Here's a review of polar coordinates. First, we start off with the relationship between rectangular coordinates in the Cartesian coordinate system. In other words, it's just the xy plane and polar coordinates. So the tie-in is that your r, your radius out to the point, here's your r, is just the Pythagorean theorem. It's just the square root of x squared plus y squared. And we know the cosine theta is adjacent over the hypotenuse, so it's x over that r, and sine is y over that r. So that ties the theta and the r to the x and the y, and their popular way of saying it is this. So in the rectangular coordinate system, you have your x, y defining your point. In the polar coordinates, you have the radius and the angle. So the angle pointing toward the point and the r radius out to it. Okay, so here's some examples. We have a pi over 4 terminating angle. All right, so that's pi over 4 radians on the unit circle. So we don't put that r, that's not that arc length there. That's just where the pi over 4 angle would have terminated on this radius 3 circle. So if this is pi over 4, then you're on the unit circle. On the unit circle, your terminal point there would have been this on the unit circle. But since it's on a radius 3 circle, you just multiply everything by 3, and that's why it's 3 squared of 2 over 2. 3 squared of 2 over 2. Of course, another way you could have figured that out was you could have said x is r cosine theta, which is 3, and cosine theta. Cosine of pi over 4, and so that would have been 3 squared of 2 over 2. Okay, now in the polar version, it has a radius 3, so you put your r first, and your angle is pi over 4. So you picture aiming to the target by aiming to the pi over 4 direction, and then shooting out, launching the missile or something, so that it hits a radius 3 away. That's the way you can view it. Here's the aim, and here's the distance out to the target. It also works with degrees, although we're primarily going to be using radians. So, 45 degrees, radius 3, gets to that point. Here's another example here. First, this point here. This point here is in rectangular coordinates, 3 comma 0. In polar, it's a 0 radian angle or a 0 degree angle, and the target is 3 units out on that ray, 3, 0. But with polar, you can name it all kinds of ways. I could name that terminating ray 2 pi radians. Here's your ray. I could do 2 pi and still a 3. I could do 360 degrees and a radius 3, and that would get me there. I could even name it backwards 3 from a pi. So I could face my target off in the pi direction and fire backwards, so to speak, with a negative radius and hit that target. See, so you can have a negative radius. It's just you face one direction, and your radius goes backwards from there, the amount of units. This point, this angle here, 7 pi over 6. Whoops. Let's go backwards with that. So here's your pi over 6 terminating angle. The point there would have been square root of 3 over 2, and 1/2, as your primary coordinates on the unit circle, but we're not on a unit circle, we're on a radius 3 circle, so 3 gets multiplied by each one, and of course you can tell that you're that in your coordinate system, this is negative and this is negative, so your x is negative and your y is negative, and then you get that point. But polar coordinates, out in the polar, you're aiming at 7 pi over 6, and you're traveling out 3 on that ray toward it. So you're aiming here, and then you're going to go out on that ray in that direction, 3 units, and hit the point. But, as I said, you can name it different ways. You can say, well, I'm going to face in the pi over 4 direction, in pi over 6 direction, sorry. That's this direction. I'm going to face out here. And then go backwards on it, 3 units, going down here. So backwards 3, facing pi over 6, gets the same point. And you can even go, well, I'm going to name this angle a different way. I'm going to name it, instead of 7 pi over 6, instead of 7 pi over 6, I'm going to rename it as negative 5 pi over 6. So let's be right here. So here's seven pi over 6 is here, but I can rename it across here. I can say it's negative 5 pi over 6 going around here to get to the same coterminal angle, and then since that's the same angle, I just have the same positive radius going out there. So this is how polar coordinates works and how it relates to rectangular coordinates.